Today I want to share information with you about the SewQ laser. It is a great sewing machine laser that is going to help you get your stitches exactly where you want them. Hi, I'm Kim Jamison-Hurst of Chatterbox Quilts, and I want to thank the SewQ laser people for sending me this product to take a look at and try out. So let's first talk about what you get with the SewQ laser kit, because you get everything you need to install and use this product. So first off, of course, you get a laser. So this is the laser here. This little part here is actually the laser. So when you're working with this and setting it up on your sewing machine, make sure you have it turned off because you do not want to accidentally get this shining in your eyes. Not a good thing. All right. So the laser has a very long cord on it. It has an on-off button here, and it has a USB attachment at the end. Now, if you have a USB port on your sewing machine, like I do on the 9450, you can plug that into your sewing machine and that will power the laser. Now, keep in mind, if you do that, that the sewing machine has to be on to provide that power to the laser. So if you are trying to turn the laser on and you can't figure out why it's not coming on, check and make sure your sewing machine is on. What if you don't have a USB port in your laser, on your sewing machine? You'd be in trouble if it wasn't on the laser. Not to worry, they've given you a power adapter here, so you can plug the USB end into that, and then you can plug that into a regular power outlet, so you can use it that way as well. And I really like the fact that you have those options. I like the fact that there's an on-off button on the laser as well. I think that's really helpful and kind of a safety precaution as well, I think. All right, now you have to place this on the machine, so you need to have a holder. So you have a holder that comes with the machine, or with laser, I should say. It's going to be on your machine, and I guess it'll come with the machine, won't it? Now, there's an up and a down on this holder, okay? It's hard to tell that, but there is. So what that means is there's only one way this laser is going to fit in. So it'll fit in one way and not the other. This is the not the other. It's not going in there, okay? I'm having problems getting it in. It just isn't going to go. And this way, you kind of snug it in there, okay? You can just kind of push that in. It takes not a lot of force, but a little bit of wiggling back and forth to get it in there, okay? So that tells me this is the right way, in other words, the top of how that laser is going to go on my machine, okay? Another way to tell the way to put the holder on your machine is that it has this curved side here, all right? That's the side that is going to be facing to the left when you put it on your sewing machine, okay? So that curved side here is going to be facing left, all right? And when you put this on the machine, when you go to put this holder on your machine, you also want to have it level. You want it, this part, parallel to your sewing machine bed as much as possible, okay? Now, what if you have a different kind of machine where the front of it, where you want to attach the laser holder, really slopes back a lot? Well, not to worry. There is also an adapter that the holder will fit into. So there's a slotted area, probably hard to see on camera here, but there is a slotted area and your holder will just fit right in there. And then you'll be able to put this part on the machine and it'll keep that holder level again. So your holder's not going to be at some strange angle. Okay. Something else that they have is this little thumb screw that you see here. Okay. So you have this little thumb screw and that is going to be used to tighten the laser once it's in the holder. So once the holder's on your machine, you put the laser in, you're going to be using this part to tighten up the laser. Now on the holder, you'll notice there's a couple of holes. Well, this side, which is flat, is going to be against your sewing machine. So that's not where the thumb screw is going to go. It's going to go on this other front part. And before you put the holder on, I suggest you take your thumb screw. This is probably the trickiest part for me, but it's not that hard really. But you're going to put the thumb screw in the hole and then you're going to go back and forth with it a little bit just to make sure that hole is drilled through nice and smoothly, okay? And then you're going to take that off for now. Okay, what about all the cabling that you have with the laser? You don't want that just hanging around, right? So you've been provided with several of these cable holders. Now, that one's actually upside down. So these are really great because they're adhesive on the back. You remove the little red part and you can stick them on your machine wherever you want them to be. So they will hold the cable really well. They actually have a bit of an indent here that's closer to the cable holder. I don't know if you can see that or not because they're clear, but the cable fits right in there and stays in those holders. So that's really helpful as well. But I would not put the cable holders on your machine until you've actually installed the holder and the laser and everything's all set up, and then you can decide where you want to have that cable run on your sewing machine. Okay, so there's a few other things that come with the SoQ laser kit. So there's an alcohol pad, which seems strange, but you want to make sure that the parts, both on the machine and on the laser holder, are nice and clean and free of any oil or grease or any dirt or anything like that to get the really good adhesive hold. So you're going to use that pad to clean your machine and the back of the holder. And also there is this, which seems really strange, doesn't it, to have? But this is integral to getting this laser set up properly. And we're going to be talking about that a little later. I'm going to show you how to do that. It's a guide to help you set up your laser so that you're going to get exactly the seam allowance that you want. So now I'm going to go and put my holder on my machine and get the laser set up and everything, and refer to the installation instructions on the SoQ Laser website. Again, the link is in the description below because they give you really good instructions on where to put that holder and how to position it to get the best results from the SoQ laser. So I'm going to go and do that now. Then I'm going to come back and show you how to use the guide to get that laser lined up just perfectly. So I've got the holder and the laser installed on the sewing machine. Now you're going to notice it's a little dark in here, okay? And the reason it's dark is because I want you to be able to see the laser as well as you can on camera. So I've put it on the Janome 9450. Might not be the right position. I'm just demoing this for you. So make sure, again, you refer to SoQ Laser's installation instructions for how to place that on your machine and what would be the best location for your machine. But you can see that the laser is operational and everything. Now, this is when we get to talk about this guide that came. Remember, we had this guide that came in the kit as well. So it's going to go down on your machine bed. Have a needle in place. Have your needle down. And you notice that there's a little V in here. That's going to go right up against your needle. There's also some horizontal lines on that guide. And that's going to be something that you can line up with maybe some markings on your machine bed. Or in my case, I'm going to line up the side of the guide with my needle plate to make sure that it's square. So you don't want to have that guide, you know, askew. All right. So we're going to line that up like that. All right. Now, you can probably see that my laser looks a bit askew. All right. And that's perfectly fine. There are kind of 2 degrees of adjustment on this laser. So let me explain that to you. You can see it's skewed. We want to have the laser beam parallel to any one of those lines on the guide, really. So to do that, you're going to turn the laser. Now my thumb screw is in the holder. We talked about the thumb screw, right? But the thumb screw is not tightened, okay? We're not going to tighten it up until we've got everything in place. And at that point in time, we will tighten it, and that's going to hold the laser exactly where we want it. So to get the laser parallel, the laser beam parallel to the lines on the guide, we're going to turn it. Okay, we're going to give a little bit of a turn here. Thumb screw might be in a little more than it should be right now. Let's see. All right. So I'm just kind of lining that up with, and I have to look over, pardon my head a bit, but I'm just wanting to make sure I get it there. So a little bit of a fine adjustment going on there. Okay. That looks pretty good to me. All right. So that's one thing, but I'm not on any of the lines I want to be on. Okay. Those lines on the guide are there for a reason. The blue lines are 1/4 inch seam allowance. And the red lines are 3/8 of an inch seam allowance. So I, being a quilter, want to look at the blue lines, and I want to line it up with the blue line that's on the right-hand side of the guide, okay? Because that's where I want to be stitching. Okay, that's where I want my seam allowance to be. So I'm going to move this now side to side, just back and forth, okay? Not turn, but back and forth, okay? I know it's probably a little hard to see exactly what I'm doing, but I'm turning like side to side, back and forth, okay? And I'm lining it up with my blue line there, which would be the edge of my 1/4 inch foot too, right? So let me get that in there. And when I've got it exactly where I want it, that's the time I'm going to tighten that thumb screw. If you want to make any adjustments to it, so I need to move it back a little bit, make sure you loosen the thumb screw first, okay? The thumb screw is there to hold the laser in place, so you don't want to try and move it around when the laser is still locked in there. Not a good idea. So now I want to make a couple of half square triangles. So I've got two pieces of fabric put together here. And the key here is to line up the laser from point to point on your fabric squares here. So as I go through, I'm going to get these lined up to start. A good suggestion is to slow down your machine a little bit when you get going at first until you get used to using this. And as I move along, I'm going to keep my eyes here and keep that laser on that point. So that's what I'm going to try and do. Yes, I'm going slow because I've got a leader in here. So we're going to stop that there and make sure I'm lined up properly, and then I can continue on my squares here. As long as it's under my foot. Okay, here we go. So I'm keeping my eye down here, keeping that laser right on that point. And this should give me a stitching line that's a quarter inch away from the diagonals there. And yes, I'm going very slow. You don't have to go this slow. Okay, I'm going to cut my threads. And then I need to go and do the same thing on the other side. I'll take off my little leader here, but I'll be doing the same thing, lining up from corner to corner and stitching, and that'll give me a quarter inch seam off that diagonal again. So I'll go and do that, and then I will show you what the half square triangles look like when I'm finished stitching and cut them open. So I got my stitching done. Now I just need to cut from diagonal to a diagonal and press them open, and we'll see what we have. So here's my two half square triangles that I made using the SoQ laser. So after working with the SoQ laser, I really like the fact that it's adjustable. So you can adjust it if you're a quilter or if you're a sewist, you can adjust to different seam allowances. The laser itself is really easy to see, nice and sharp. So that's going to keep you accurate with your stitching. And something else I hadn't mentioned about it is the fact that you can actually take the laser off your one machine, just pull it out of its holder, and you can put it on another machine and get another holder and put it on another machine if you want. So you could just get the laser and then move it to different machines and use it, you know, if you have more than one machine in your studio. If you'd like to get your own SoQ laser, please check the description below for the link to do so. So thanks again to SoQ Laser for sending me this product to review. And if you're looking for more helpful quilting information, please be sure to check out my website at www.chatterboxquilts.com.